Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial we are going to make two simple short animations in PowerPoint using shapes. So the first animation is inspired by one of the animation by Abhishek, Ghosh at behance.net, and the second animation is inspired by one of the animation by Andrew Wang at pinterest.com. So let's get started, and first of all we will create this one. And for that I will move back to the PowerPoint, and here you can see that I have already created this presentation, and the first animation has been created on four different slides. However, you can also apply all the animation effects on a single slide as well, but to make it easy I have duplicated the slides and just changed the animation effects. And the second animation has been created on a single slide, and that one is very easy. And now let's see how to make this. For that I will go to the file menu and will click on blank presentation. We'll change the layout to blank, and now I will insert a oval shape. And for that I will first zoom in by holding the control key and then use middle mouse button to zoom in or zoom out. So let's say I first insert a shape from the insert tab, and here I choose an oval and just click inside the slide to insert a default 2.4 cm by 2.4 cm oval. So now you can hold down Ctrl Shift and Alt keys while reducing the size. That way it will reduce the size simultaneously from all the sides. So now I will change the fill color to black and will also apply a black outline. Now I will make a duplicate of this oval by copy or paste, or you can also hold down Ctrl Shift keys while dragging and dropping to make a duplicate. Now I will just remove the fill color of this second oval. We'll now position both of these ovals right at this point, and this is just for an illustration, and we'll also drag and drop this one on top. Now zoom in, and first of all I will apply the motion path to this first oval by moving to the animations tab, click add animation drop down button, choose more motion path, and here I will choose up motion path, hit the OK key. And now I need to reduce the length of this motion path, and I will just apply up to this point like this. Now set it to play with previous with the duration of 1.50 seconds. Also open the animation pan and double click on this effect and apply the auto reverse, because we want this oval to move up and reverse back to its same position. You can also change the smoothness type if you want to, like you can remove this start smoothness and just held the end smoothness, and from the timing tab repeat it until end of the slide. Hit the OK key, and you can see the preview right now by enabling this auto preview. And now if I will apply another animation, it will show you the preview right here. So the next animation is again motion path. And this time I want to apply the motion path to the second oval, and for that I will first open the selection pan by clicking the select drop down button and choose selection pan. And here you can see that we have applied the motion path to oval 3, and now we need to apply on oval 6. However, it is almost impossible to select the oval 6 because both of these objects are on top of each other. So I will hide this oval 3 temporary by clicking on this I button, and now I will apply the down motion path to this oval by moving to more motion path and choose down motion path, and will reduce the length of this motion path, let's say up to this point. Now again I need to configure the properties of this animation. Let's say I remove the start smoothness, choose auto reverse, set it to play with previous with a duration of 1.5 seconds, and I need to repeat this effect until end of the slide. Okay, now I will again move to the selection pane, will show all the objects. You can check out the length of both of the motion path, and if you see a difference then you can readjust the length of the motion path. Now let's see the slideshow. Okay, that seems fine. I will just move the position a little bit down at this point. Okay, now I want to fill the entire slide with these two ovals. So I will select both of them. Now we'll hold down the control and shift keys and we'll drag and drop to the bottom and make sure to, so let's say I want to drop it right here. Now you can start tapping F4 key to make further duplicates. Again, select all these four, hold down the control and shift keys and drag and drop to the right. Now start tapping F4 key to repeat the last command and fill the slide with these ovals. So it is totally up to you that how much size of the ovals you want, how many ovals you want on a single slide, and how much length you want to give to the up and down motion path. So let's see the slideshow, and there we have the animation ready. So that was the technique that we applied on this presentation. Now let's look into the second animation, and you just need to create a single slide and then you can replicate as many slides you want to increase the length of the animation. So first of all, I will go to the insert tab, will click on shift drop down button and will choose line and will draw a very short line here like this. Now we'll zoom in and we'll open the format shape pan by clicking on this button. And here I will first increase the width of the line up to 8 points, let's say, and we'll change the cap type to round. And now I want to make two more duplicates of this line, short line, but before that I would like to apply the spin animation on it and then change the effect options to half spin, and the position is clockwise, set it to play with previous. Duration is 1.50. You can increase or decrease the duration according to the speed of the animation that you want. And also open the animation pan, double click the effect to open the effect option property window, and I want to apply start smoothness of 1 second, and we don't need to change anything in the timings tab. Hit the OK key, and now I will make a duplicate of this line by holding control and shift keys and just drag and drop it below like this, and now tap F4 key to repeat the same command. Now all the three lines have the same spin animation effect. Now I will select all these three lines, will hold down the control and shift keys and will drag and drop them right here. Now tap F4 to repeat the last command. So see the slideshow. Okay, or if you want to move them counterclockwise, then select all of them and just change them to counterclockwise. As we now have three vertical lines ready, we need three horizontal lines as well. So instead of drawing from the scratch and applying the animation effect, we will again copy these three lines. You can also use copy and paste command from the home tab. Drag and drop them to the side way. And now I will make a group of these 9 short lines. Go to the shape format, click group drop down button and choose group. And now rotate them to 90 degree left. And adjust the position. These red guides will help you to see the exact position of the objects. So now I will select them and will ungroup them. So as I group them, you can see that it has removed all the 9 animation effects from these lines. So I again need to apply the spin animation effect, but before that I need to ungroup them. And now instead of applying animation effect, what I can do, I can select this one, go to the animations tab and double click on animation painter, and then start clicking on those objects on which you want to apply the same animation effect. So it will also show you preview after each click. So if you don't want to see the preview, you can temporarily turn it off from the auto preview option. And now just start tapping on these 9 lines to apply the same animation effect. Now to close the animation painter, you can again click on this button or you can press the escape key. Now if you see the slideshow, then it will rotate like this. So now I will select these 9 lines, will drag and drop them to the bottom to make duplicate, and will place them to the left at this position, let's say, and will also copy these 9 lines and will place them to the right at this position. So now I will select them again and will change the rotation type to clockwise, and this one also to clockwise. Now again I will select all of these lines and will just drag and drop them to the bottom to make further copies. So you can change the spin type anytime to counterclockwise or clockwise. Now right click on the background and choose format background, apply a solid fill black color, and I also want to change the color of all these lines. Go to the shape format, shape outline, and I want to apply this orange color. Now let's see the slideshow. So now to repeat the same animation effect, I will go to the thumbnail view and will right click on the slide and will choose duplicate slide, and that way it will repeat this animation 2 times. Now again I will make another duplicate, but this time on the third slide I will change the animation effects from counterclockwise to clockwise and clockwise to counterclockwise. Like this. And now I will also make a duplicate of this slide to increase the length of the animation. Now we have 4 slides and each slide contains an animation effect of 1.5 seconds. So if you want to add a delay between both of these slides and want to continuously run this slideshow in a loop, then you first need to apply the transition timing. Let's say I apply a duration of 1.50 seconds for the first slide, then again I move to the second slide, and here I will apply 2 seconds. So that way after showing both of these slides, it will pause for half a second before showing the third slide. So again on the third slide, 1.50, and for the fourth slide I will again choose 2 seconds. So it is totally up to you that how much duration you want to give to each slide. And now I will move to the slideshow tab, will click on setup slideshow, and will make a check mark on loop continuously until escape, hit the OK key. Go to the first slide and now run the slideshow, and it will run in a continuous loop. So I hope you will like this presentation. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Bye and take care.